Jack Tomczak. That's Andrew Lee.
Happy Monday, everybody. Thanks for joining us.
Show produced by Lump.
Hello, Lump.
Good morning.
How's everybody's weekend?
Wonderful.
Fabulous.
Wonderful. Had a great weekend. Won some money playing poker.
I don't know when we asked you how your weekend was before the show started. It was more like it was good.
Yeah, it was all right. It was fine.
It's okay.
He's acting. He's in character.
The curtain has risen, Lump.
Yeah.
It is time to exaggerate.
He's done being Andy Leibovitz. Now he's Andrew Lee.
Yeah, time to go.
Character.
Time to do a show. That was nice. I did go see Batman versus Superman. We reviewed that on the show Friday. Mm-hmm. And if you haven't seen Friday's behind the scenes video, I implore you your earliest opportunity.
Do it.
To go check it out. But right stop now. It before the last 10 seconds because it gets kind of gory.
It gets
violent.
Don't let your kids watch that.
It's not safe
for life.
Goes from PG to a solid PG-13.
It took...
Right there at the end.
It took a very long time.
I imagine.
For something that is very short.
I imagine it did. You put a lot of effort into that video.
The second part was quicker and easier than the first part with the credits.
Yeah.
Because I had my kids crawling all over me for the first part. But, yes, check out the video at the Up and Anna blog at TwinCitiesNewsTalk.com. Watch the first part and the last part and the stuff in the middle.
The stuff in the middle is good, too.
I think it is.
I think it's good.
That was the problem when making it. I just got caught up in just watching us be funny. Great.
But I echo your review of the movie.
Yeah.
It was fine.
Is it worth seeing?
Yeah. Yeah.
If you got 2.5 hours to kill.
Oh, God.
and you want to...
Well, and that's just for the movie.
Assault your eyes.
You got the trailers.
Yeah, a lot of trailers.
Yeah.
Yeah. And solid again, 3 hours with the trailers.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, no, it's great. I mean, it's entertaining. It's fine. There's a lot going on. Good action, good visuals. It's empty calories.
They could have done better in the plot department.
Yes. It's an empty calorie mm-hmm. movie. Walk out of the movie not quite feeling like you consumed mm-hmm. anything.
Yeah.
It was okay.
There's
Ben Affleck was much better than I expected, though.
Yeah.
I mean, when you first heard that Ben Affleck was going to be Batman, everybody kind of groaned and rolled their eyes.
We saw Daredevil.
He was good.
Stop it.
He did a good job.
Yeah.
He did a fine job. I'm becoming less and less of a fan as, what's his name, Henry Cavill as Superman.
No.
Why?
No, I love him.
He's great as
Because
Superman.
He's attractive?
Because I love him.
Because he's attractive?
Don't question my love.
Okay, I won't.
Yeah, because he's attractive.
Right.
Yeah. That's why he's an actor.
And all the muscles. His jaw is beautiful.
He's just, that whole movie was just so earnest.
Well, and that,
and it's just like, oh, just come on. I mean, a little levity isn't going to kill anybody, is it?
And
a little bit?
That's the tough part with Superman is that they've built the character up to be so iconic and bigger than everything. You can't really have levity. It's always just, well, the man could destroy our planet, so everything he does is very serious.
Right.
One thing I didn't mention on Friday about the movie, that Wonder Woman saves the day?
More or less.
In this instance, way...
Spoiler alert!
Well, I mean...
I wouldn't...
Batman still dies.
I wouldn't have even known that Wonder Woman was in the movie.
Saves the day up until that point.
It is all ruined for me.
Yeah. She was in the trailer.
I didn't watch the trailer.
On Friday she was in it.
Right. We talked about it on Friday.
I didn't watch the trailer.
We gave you the actress's name. Did you listen to the show you're on?
But I did like Jesse Eisenberg, though. I thought Jesse Eisenberg did a good job.
And I thought...
He was a good villain.
I thought he could have dialed it back.
No, I think, if anything, that movie needs to be dialed up more in terms of characters and eccentricities and quirkiness and things like that. I mean, that's the type of stuff that you get.
And a Marvel fan over here, everybody.
You get connected to. So I thought Jesse Eisenberg was really good.
If you're the kind of person who's going to see this, you might be a little...
Everybody...
It's not great. If you're just a regular moviegoer who likes noise and colors and stuff... Mm-hmm. It's fine.
It set some records. I think it was the biggest DC opening weekend ever for a DC movie.
Thus proving few people listen to this show before going to see movies.
Well, I think people had already made up their mind whether or not they're going to see it before reviews started coming out. I know that that's the case for me.
Yeah.
I mean, when I heard about it, when I saw the trailers, I was like, okay, I made a sort of a mental decision. All right, I am going to go see that.
Yeah.
And the reviews started to come out, and I kind of shrugged and was a little disappointed. But once it came time to go see it, I was like, yeah, sure, whatever, yeah. I'll go see it.
I've seen Superman for Quest for Peace like 5 times.
Yeah.
I see anything Superman related, I will go see.
Right. And I think that's the case for a lot of people. They've made up their mind they were going to go see this movie regardless of the reviews and decide for themselves. You're zapping me with your eyes.
I'm trying. It doesn't work on Mondays. So go see movies. Enjoy life.
It cracked the top 10 opening weekends of all time. And the interesting note of it is, the angle of it is the only movie in the top 10 of opening weekends of all time that has a poor Rotten Tomatoes score.
Oh.
Like, if you look at all the top 10 opening weekend movies, the lowest Rotten Tomatoes score before this movie was like 75 or 77%. And this one was down in the
30s on Friday.
30s-ish. Yeah. On Friday. Yeah, so that's the first one to have a really a bad critic score.
Okay, so it's commercially though, it's successful.
Which
so
means we're
going to
get more of them.
Which is that I'm happy about that.
Right. No lesson will be learned.
Zack Snyder should stop directing movies.
He should
be some type of like
producer,
cinematographer.
Yeah,
you
exactly.
know, you handle the pretty parts, but leave like the directing,
the
to somebody
story
else.
Part to someone else.
Well, and with Bruce Wayne's character, they barely did any introduction to him. Why is he so angry? What's with the outfit? On the show today at 7 o'clock, we'll talk with Chris Holbrook with the Libertarian Party of Minnesota, what that organization thinks of Jesse Ventura, who is not running for president. Don't believe him. Also, Dr. John Spry will come in to talk about education or something.
We're not sure.
I don't know. He just said, I'm coming in.
He sent us a bunch of stuff. Did you read any of it?
I read the headlines. There's a piece in the Star Tribune that mentions and talks about John Spry and his view and every economist's view on trade. We'll talk about that and also private school vultures in South Dakota. I read it. At 8, Sean Moran. I don't know who that is. Andrew, you booked this.
He's with the National Border Patrol Council, which is a union that represents Border Patrol agents. The president of the NBPC testified in front of Congress recently, basically saying that the arrest rates of Middle Eastern men coming across our southern border have skyrocketed this year. They've surged this year, specifically people from Afghanistan and Pakistan. And the testimony was in front of Congress and got kind of a big story. So I reached out to the organization to see if someone would come on the show and talk about it. So Sean will be here at 8 o'clock.
Yeah, with the immigration discussion, people like to paint those of us who would like a secure border as
xenophobic,
racist, and people from Mexico are just coming here to make a living. Sure, I get that.
Some of them are,
but if you're not checking credentials coming through, anybody from anywhere,
exactly,
including bad guys,
exactly,
can get through.
You want to talk about Homeland Security? You want to talk about protecting Americans and America, keeping America safe? Well, that conversation, in my mind, begins at the southern border. If we're not going to have a secure border, if we're not going to try to keep track of who's coming in here, then there's no point in anything we're doing in the Middle East, any of this other stuff, any gun control measures, anything. And all that stuff is moot if we're not going to take the minimal effort. Honestly, when you look at all the things this country does, the effort and resources that it would take to just shore up our border more than it already is would be minimal.
Do you lock your doors at night? I mean,
right.
Come on.
You like your car?
Right. All right, Andrew, what's the top of the news bag?
Vice President Al Franken.
Huh?